time.
What's up, peoples? Look at y'all.
On traffic.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Hello. The whole posse. What's up, Mr. Bell? Peoples, I'll be forgetting about you. You know that, right?
That's okay.
I'm going too, yeah. Oh, sorry, Mr. Wilbert. Mr. Wowens. How you doing, Mr. Wowens?
My
Just want to say, first of all, I want to commend the parents. Just what Ms. Bell and them are doing, and Mr. Henderson, just reading those emails and seeing how focused everybody is about the team, especially the parents. That's all me and Ms. Kimber was talking about. It gives you, you know, even more of a commitment to want to help the team go forward. So I just want to say thank you for the parents. And I mean, with that, it really gets, go ahead, give my hand. Yeah. I think without you, none of this is possible. And they're really, you know, the fundraisers, just all that good stuff. It makes me just want to give even more. And that's, like I said, that's all we were talking about. What can we do? You know, you figure you give it 2 more years with the parents like this. Guys, I guarantee if you want to become a national champion, you're going to be a national champion and world champion. But it takes that sort of support and camaraderie. And even when she was telling me, you know, just to hear about you guys being on the bus together, I told her, we will never drive again. We will all be on the bus. I just think because those moments of cracking vans, whatever it is, planes, those moments of just coming together, laughing and joking and talking and getting to know each other is like so important. So just the emotions are just overwhelming because that's all we really wanted. And, you know, being here today when you, you know, seeing you guys come in with your sweats and just seeing a real team and thanking Mr. Jeff. But once again, let's give him a hand. You know, I know you. Yeah, we got partners this time. Last year, you know, he was giving us the suburban type of. Sorry, don't leave that alone. All right. But yeah, just seeing everybody coming in, just wanting everybody to go there tomorrow and just give it your best. Remember, we're a team. We don't settle for anything but giving it your personal best, regardless of what happens, because this is like. I think we were looking at the magazine, they said you can expect well over 173,000 people to be in attendance at this event. That's like a neighborhood within itself, you know what I'm saying? And then you can expect probably like 18,000 or some competitors in all different sports. And that's good for you. It gives you a chance to showcase your talent and your skills. But we always prepare for the worst and we hope for the best. So regardless of what goes on, you go out there and you give it your very best. Remember, this is a stepping stone towards just a little bit more of, like I was saying, that personal greatness. It's just a stepping stone. Point MMA, Kung Fu Forms, Kung Fu Weapons, all that stuff, right?
In fitness,
okay.
If the parents, when you go there tomorrow, you can pay for your spectator tickets there. They didn't do those in advance. But once you guys get your registration, we cannot get it. I tried to get it. They will give it to each individual person. You have to go there and give them your name. If anything is wrong, just come and get me or Ms. Bell or Ms. Rabia. We'll figure it out. Their electricity just came back on this week, so they're kind of in a scramble to get it all together. And with over 175,000 people in attendance and everything going on, you can imagine how flustered they are. So we have to be patient, kind, and courteous. Something is wrong or whatever, we'll fix it, we'll make it happen, and all of that. That was a big thing that I had to say about that.
Just so everybody knows, because it took us a while to figure it out. All right, so the convention center is right across the street.
Okay, I want you guys in your gear, focused, and ready to compete. Everybody understand?
Yes, ma'am.
If you do not do that, you will be fined $50 team fine. If anybody gets a fine, the team fine will go back in the kitty to Ms. Bell.
Why are you making drinks?
Understand?
Yes, ma'am. Sorry, I'm just talking to myself, talking out loud. They got drinks and fruit and stuff there.
This moment, and so after, you can sit down, Miss Mia. So after you guys are done competing, I don't want no playing around, no phones, no video games, none of that. I need you focused and ready to compete at your absolute 100% best. Once you're done competing, you guys can hang out together and socialize with each other. I never want to see you by yourself, always with your team. You go to the bathroom, I want groups. You go to get something to eat, I want groups. And every group must have an adult in it. Understand? There's way too many people for you guys to be by yourself, running around and not in your group. So I'll text Ms. Bell the time and she'll text it to everybody what time we're gonna meet over there at the food court. So she can make sure that everybody's up and ready. What now, especially the guys that are sharing a room, if they say get up at 5, you should get up at 4:30 because you're sharing one bathroom. You gotta do that, okay? So if you're sharing a room with somebody, you gotta make sure you allow time to get up and get ready and get down there on time. No lateness, none of that, okay? I really wanna reiterate, nobody by themselves. Stay with your team the entire time, okay?
Ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So, and when we get over there, Mr. Murray, because Mr. Raymond is going to be filming, and Mr. Glover and Mr. Owens are going to be judging. So you're in charge of just making sure everybody's keep warming up. And you're in charge of making sure nobody goes nowhere without you talking to you. And then you go to one of the parents and tell them what to do. Mr. Hennis, you,
he's okay? He's the parent coach. But so you, James, and him.
But your goal is to, whenever somebody see, look over there in that area, they want to see all you guys warming up together as a group, stretching as a group, all that good stuff. Keep the blood going, keep everything circulating. And like I said again, let's go out there and give it our very best. And whatever happens, no tears, no getting upset, because it's not nothing personal. Just a warm up for greatness, okay?
Yes,
so keep up the good job. And once again, I just want to, you know, I know I'm saying it again. You guys, give them parents a hand, because all the parents. You guys got to be really blessed to have your moms and your dads and them coming out and doing the fundraisers. They really care about you. And all you got to do is just remember, just never disrespect them.
And
so
one other thing, there's nobody on the sideline taking a nap. You stay until the very last person is done competing. So if Amari is winning and he goes 9 o'clock tomorrow night, we stay until he's done. Understand? That's how it works as a team. We rise together, we fall together. We get tired together, we get tired together, okay? That's how it's gonna work. And then nobody's leaving to go eat. Everybody leaves together to go to the food court to eat lunch after you're done competing. That's why the parents are bringing snacks and stuff to get you guys through the day, okay? So I don't want nobody saying, I'm hungry, and crying to your parent that you wanna go eat or any of that mess. You're there to do your job and get it done. Competition. If you want to be a champion, those are the sacrifices you have to make, okay? There are plenty of snacks and stuff that the parents have. I have stuff, although mine is healthy. A lot of people don't like them, but you're more than willing to share with me, okay? I don't have a problem with that. Messiah knows he is not going to go nowhere to eat until he is done competing. Once you guys are done competing, somebody will take you all to the food court. You guys can sit down there, have some pizza or whatever you want together as a team and relax and chill, okay? So, anything any of the parents need to say or want to say, bad attitude, all of that, it's going to be a team fine. Every team fine is $50. It goes back in the kitty. Everybody understand? And you can't ask your parents for the money. So you want to figure a way to get your own money. Because your parent didn't get you the fund, okay? You got yourself the fund. So Mr. Mario and Mr. James and Mr. Henderson gonna be on y'all so y'all don't get no funds. Although we trying to raise the kitty. We ain't trying to raise it through negative funds.
Yeah.
Anything else, Professor? Yeah. Look, make sure you get the name on the jacket. It says Zarian. Agreement I had mine. For my old bully. We're doing this job for that. I'm not joking no more. It's time to go. Alright, ready, Sai?
Yes.
You are funny, my friend. Oh, you're serious? No, Horace?
Who was that, Dale?
Who's the richest and most
I'll be back in a little bit, okay?
We don't need
that.
Would
you go, please?
I'm private as a utopian collective.
Alright, if I need it, I don't really need it. Because he's got his bag, I just gotta carry mine. Oh my god. Sorry.
All right, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
There you go,
it's not that cold still.
No, it's not as bad.
It's supposed to be
I think.
Thank you. And now to sing our national anthem. He's a 41-year veteran of traditional karate and other martial arts. 10-year MC here at the Arnold. Would you please welcome Master Kevin Collier.
Yeah.
here that's an Eagle Scout. We have a gentleman that's an Eagle Scout. His name is Vincent Neely. It's the man of the hour, Mr. Arnold.
Come on! right now.
Pastor Paul, Pastor Paul, would you please report to the announcer's table, Pastor Paul Kali.
Let's go!
Let's go!
Stop pushing his hands though!
Fight, 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 fight.
With our scores on the field, we got some 48, Christian Peter 60, Joe Daniels 45, and Douglas team is 34. Good job. Then right now, 2 minutes. Number 10 on deck, and Jennifer Arnold, and then the
birthday
performer, Vanessa Ayer,
and
Sherry, and
what
is
the
season? Back in 1 morning, going to the edges. We have 1 minute.
Next time.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ready? One of the best guys in the business. You see him here everywhere. Give it up for Chuck Zito in the house, ladies and gentlemen. Chuck Zito.
All right, guys. Client number 9. Client number 1, Alabama. Three, two, one.
Get that leverage! Spread those legs! Oh! Get up! Thank you. Thank you. somewhere.
Hands on the hips, one knee in the middle. There you go.
out the way, by the way. And lucky I didn't convince you that you're not on the set. That's what happened. I mean, it's the end of the game. It's the end of the game. I didn't know the difference. I didn't know the difference. They did exactly what they said they would do. And I'll be glad to work.